It's here. Create Studio Pro has dropped. Today I'm going to show you what's new in Create Studio Pro, the next level version of Create Studio. If you're not familiar with Create Studio, it is a platform that allows you to create videos or animations. It's really designed to be simple so anyone can use it. You don't have to be a professional video editor or a professional animator to use Create Studio. Now, I've reviewed Create Studio a couple times on this channel already, and just like before, this video is not sponsored, but I do want to let you know that Create Studio did give me access to Create Studio Pro for free. So I just want to be clear about that. If you like what you see, there's a link in the description where you can purchase Create Studio Pro. So just a quick overview about Create Studio if you are not familiar with it. It basically started as an animation program where you could do 2D or 3D animations. What was really great about it is that you could have a character do multiple actions in one scene. It was super easy to use. But over the years, Create Studio has just kept developing this platform, and now it integrates a lot of other features like these scroll stoppers. You can make whiteboard videos. It comes with a music library. There's a text to speech feature, which I know a lot of people like. And you can also upload your own media and integrate that into your Create Studio projects. Now, if you want a deeper dive into any of those things I talked about, I'm going to link some older videos I made about Create Studio down in the description box so you can check that out. But today I'm really going to focus on what's new and exciting, in my opinion, with Create Studio Pro. They've made a lot of improvements to some of the existing components of the program. They've changed a lot of the functionality of the timeline, for instance. They've added some features to characters where you can actually loop the actions on characters, and you can download those characters faster into your project because they actually made the file sizes lighter. They also have a screen recording and webcam component as well. But I'm going to show you the three things that I think are the most fun that is new in Create Studio. Let's just dive right into that. So here is Create Studio Pro when you first open it. And let's just start by heading over to the top left of the screen and selecting new project. Now here is where you can access a lot of different templates that are already pre-designed for you in Create Studio Pro. And some of these are things that you might have heard me talk about already, like these scroll stoppers, doodle videos. But you can also start with a blank project because there are so many assets in Create Studio. What you could create in this platform is endless. It's really limitless. So let's start with that blank file. And you can see here that you can select your aspect ratio. You can do a landscape, square, or vertical format. I'm going to make a 4K landscape project, and we're going to have the canvas color. That's just like the background. It's just going to be white. And let's create a project. All right, let's just do a quick tour of Create Studio if you haven't seen this before. Down here is your timeline. This is where we're going to add all of our elements and decide what sequence they are going to appear in. Over here is where you can access all the different assets, and we're gonna get way into that. Up here are some tools that will come in very handy. And this right pane over here changes depending on what component we're working on in Create Studio. So for instance, if you are working with a text component, that's where you would like change the font and the size and the color and everything like that. But what we're gonna work on right now is a really new feature that I think is so fun. You can create bobblehead animations in Create Studio Pro. This is brand new, hot off the presses, and it's really fun. Let me show you how. So the first thing you wanna do is import a photo of yourself or whomever you want to be in your bobblehead. I've got this funny cutout of myself that I used for a recent thumbnail. And what I need to do is just section out my head and my hair for my bobblehead. So I'm gonna head up to the top of the screen and grab this pen tool. And I'm just going to click around my head and cut out my hair and my face. This is what I love about this Create Studio Pro. This particular function is so professional, just like you would use in a professional product, like let's say Adobe Illustrator or Photoshop. You just use your mouse to click, but if you want these points to be smooth and curved as opposed to linear, you just click and drag. It is the same functionality you would get in many other professional platforms. You can also zoom into the screen by hitting Command+. plus on your keyboard. And then if you want to move around the screen, just hold down your space bar and click and drag, just like any other professional platform. You guys, while I'm cutting out my little bobblehead here, if you like this video, let me know. Give me that thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, and ring the bell so you never miss a future upload. And you're just gonna close up your shape by re-clicking on the first point that you made. And then you can go back and tweak any of these points and fine-tune your cutout. So what I've done is cut out my head and my hair, and we're gonna use that as a mask over the photograph of myself to cut out that head and hair. So to do that is so simple. You're just gonna click and drag both the photograph and your pen shape. So you can see I've got two bounding boxes here. That's how I know I've selected both of my elements. And I'm going to right click and select mask. And there is my head. Now I'm gonna right click this again and I'm going to select take snapshot. And so now I have just my head here as its own separate element. So I'm gonna delete the original image I have here in my timeline. And let's start building our scene. So to do that, I'm gonna head over to the top left of the screen and select this icon for studio. We're gonna go to backgrounds, and I wanna put myself on a beach. So what I'm going to do is head down to the Supreme category. These are these really fun 2D illustrations that are backgrounds. And I'm going to search in the search field for beach, and I'm gonna select this beach image here, and I'm just gonna click and drag it into my canvas and scale it up so that it fills the whole frame. Now let's head down to characters. And we're gonna select here bobbleheads. I'm gonna clear out my search field for beach. And here are all the bodies that you can stick your head on. I'm gonna grab this one and drop it into my scene. And now to see the motion on this, just head down to your timeline and hit the space bar, and we can see what that body is doing. She's waving. All right, let's add our head to this body. So we're gonna head over to the media tab. I'm gonna grab my head here and I'm gonna place it on this body. I'm gonna resize it a little. And in my timeline, I'm gonna make sure everything's aligned. Now I want my head to kind of wiggle back and forth to sort of match the motion of the body. So I'm gonna select that head here in my timeline. I can see the bounding box around it. I'm gonna head to the top right of the screen where it says motion, and we're gonna select the loop option here, and then we're going to select rotation, and we're going to check the swing box. And now you can see here in my timeline, the swing has been applied to just the center of my head element. Let me just play that back so you can see. It's just swinging for that one quick section. If I wanted to swing the entire time, I just grab these handles and extend the swing the entire duration of my head. Now, if I wanted to swing faster, I just select that element. And over here on the preset settings, I can increase the number of loops, which means it's going to rotate a lot faster. And then let's make one other adjustment to this head. I really want the swing to originate right here at my chin. So we need to change what's called the anchor point. So I'm going to select my bobblehead, head over to settings at the top right of the screen, and select anchor point. And you can see it here, this little purple icon here in my canvas. So I'm going to put it here on my chin. And there you go, that is so cute. Now, I actually want this character to animate in, but because it's two components, I need to group them to make them one component that I can apply an animation to. So it's super simple to do that. You can do it in a few ways. The way I find is easiest is to just click and drag in your timeline to highlight both of those elements, and you can see I've got the bounding boxes over both of those elements. And then I'm going to right click and select group, and watch what happens in my timeline. Now it's become just one element that I can move around. And what I'm going to do now is select that, head over to the top right of the screen, select motion, let's stay on position, and let's click this first one here, right. So you'll see what happens is my character is gonna slide in from the right. If you want it to happen slower, you can just extend this motion down here in your timeline and it'll slow it down. If you want it to happen faster, just shrink it up. All right, that is our bobblehead look. Let's publish it by heading to the top right of the screen. You can select your output file. I'm gonna leave it on MP4 and then hit the select button and save it into your folder. My next favorite feature in Create Studio Pro is the carousel, which is great for showing off products. Let's create a new project. I'm going to make this one square over here in the top right. I can change it. And let's import the media that I want to incorporate into this project. I could just drag them right into Create Studio and they're going to upload really quickly. And then to get to the carousel, we're going to head over to Components. This is this hexagon here. And we're going to drop in this feature, the carousel. So I've dropped in the carousel, but I want to make these drop zones square as opposed to landscape. So I'm going to head over here to choose a preset and I'm going to select this one here. Now let me just play this for you and show you what it looks like. That looks great, doesn't it? So now let's start filling in these boxes with our images. So I'm just going to drag my first image and drop it into the carousel. Let's move to the next one and we'll put this photo in here. And then let's play down the timeline to our next image. And there's our third. Let's jazz this up a little bit. I want to change the color of the background of my canvas. So to do that, I'm just going to click over here outside of my carousel. And then on the right side here, I can change the canvas color to anything I want. All right, now let's spice this up with a little bit of text. So let's head over to the text tool at the top of the screen here. If you're curious what you're looking at, this is actually my merch. It all says Always in Motion. If you don't know, I have a separate YouTube channel that is dedicated to Apple's Final Cut Pro editing software and their motion graphics platform called Apple Motion. I am always in motion. So if you're interested in learning about that, check out that second channel. I will put a card up right here. And now what I'm going to do is select both of those text elements, right click and group them. And then I'm going to right click again and take a snapshot of that text and you're going to see why later. All right, now I'm going to modify that text. So I'm going to double click it to open the group. I'm going to head back to the main timeline and I'm going to take a snapshot of this. And then one more time, we're going to open that group. I'm going to change this one to Law of Motion. Head back to the main timeline. And once again, take a snapshot of that. Now, why did I make all of those snapshots? I'm going to show you in a second. All right, now I'm going to delete this group and I'm going to go back to components and I'm going to add another carousel. Let's choose a preset again and again, make this square. Let's head over to our media again and first grab that text. And we're actually going to drop that snapshot of that text into the carousel. And you can see here that it is getting cropped out of the frame because it's too big. Let's head over to the right side of the screen. Under scaling, we're going to switch it to contain. And now it fits within our square. Let's move down to the next window in our carousel. We're going to drop in this next snapshot that says spin. We've already set this carousel to contain, so that one fits right in there. And then let's head further down and we're going to grab our third piece of text. All right, now what I want is these carousels to be in different positions. So I'm going to take this second carousel and move it down to the bottom of our square window, and this top carousel I'm going to move up. All right, now I'm going to add a little bit more visual interest to this. Let's head over to the studio. And let's head on over to elements. And there's all these fun abstract elements that we can add here. I'm gonna select this one here. I'm gonna download it real quick. And I'm gonna drop it into my canvas. And now it's on top of my photos, which is not what I want. So I'm going to actually head over to the timeline and drag it under the two carousels. I'm gonna scale it up and reduce the opacity. Let's head back over to studio and add something a little different. Let's go with these lines. I'm going to drop these in the frame again, bring them under all the elements in my project. Then let's head on over to the effects bin over here on the left side of the screen. And let's add a color fill to that last element. And this is where we can change the color of those lines. I think a yellow seems kind of fun with this. Let's head back over to settings and I'm gonna dial down the opacity on that one a little bit as well. So there's the carousel. I love this for social media like Instagram. It's really eye-catching and it kind of is a really fun creative way to turn still images into a moving animation. All right, are you ready for the third thing that I love about Create Studio Pro? Let's start a new project. Once again, I'm going to start with a square project. Let's change this canvas color. Maybe to something like that. Now, this is what I think is really exciting about the new Create Studio Pro is that they have partnered with Giphy so that you can incorporate GIFs into your content, which I don't know. I think that's super fun. Let me show you how it works. If you head over to Media, You can see all of the different partners they have, Pexels, Pixabay, and here's Giphy. I'm going to search for a GIF, or you might say GIF. And when you find the GIF that you want, you just click it to import it into your files, then head up to My Files, and there is your GIF. You can drop it here into your canvas. And the entire duration we can see down in our timeline of this image is only a little over a second. You can actually loop it really easily here to extend the length of it. So now I'm about 9 seconds long at 5 loops. That might be a little much. There we go. Now let's add some text. I'm going to extend the text the length of my project. I'm gonna have the text come in a little bit later than the start of my project, but have it go all the way to the end. Let's add some motion to this text. So I'm going to select my first line of text up here, head over to motion, go to skew, and let's select right. And then let's select the bottom text, head over to motion on that one, skew, and let's go left. All right, let's add a little more sparkle to this. I'm going to head over to Studio, be selected on all here, and I'm going to search Confetti. And I'm going to grab this one, Confetti 6, drop it into my field here. And let me just show you how it looks as it is. So they just kind of pop in. Let's add an in animation to that. So I'm going to select it in my timeline, head on over to Motion. And on Position, let's select Top. And so the confetti's gonna fly up and then fall down. So that's my third favorite new element in Create Studio Pro. So what are my final thoughts on Create Studio Pro? I'm not surprised by how much I like this. Every time Create Studio offers a new update, it has so many new components and features and assets. It's a platform that is constantly evolving and growing. So all the things I liked about it before, the 3D character animation, the 2D character animation are still there. And then they added the scroll stoppers, they added a camera, they added more and more content. And now we're just like leveling up with Create Studio Pro. I'm really into those bobbleheads. I just think they're so fun and creative. And that carousel is just, I think, gonna be a winner for a lot of people. Create Studio Pro, in my mind, is for someone who kind of runs maybe a social media agency where they're creating a lot of content for different people and they want to have a lot of versatility so they can create a lot of different looks depending on their client needs. Or it's maybe someone who is a Fiverr creator who wants to be able to offer many different types of animations for potential clients. You know, Create Studio does it all. Create Studio Pro is amazing with the new functionalities that they've improved upon in the platform, and then also these new features that they've added. So I say Create Studio Pro is a thumbs up. Once again, the guys at Vidello, the makers of Create Studio, are always stepping it up. They are definitely the leaders in this kind of animation platform. And I just always, I give a round of applause. You guys, if you want to check out Create Studio Pro, I've linked to it down in the comments. If you liked this video, if you want to see any other product reviews, let me know in the comments. I read all the comments. Thanks for hanging out with me today, you guys. I'll see you again.